It's showtime.
Hey, welcome to Did You Watch Survivor Last Night? This is the only Survivor podcast. My name is Jake Scheidel. Each week I ask my best friend, Thomas Powell, if he did indeed watch a certain reality show. Hey, Thomas, how you doing today?
Jake, I'm doing great. It's a three-day weekend honoring all of our fallen Survivor contestants.
R.I.P. to Sunday, all about. Most recently.
Everyone that was voted off the island.
Oh, shit. Yeah, everybody who's ever been voted off the island, we were remembering today. A lot of people are calling the 9/11 of May.
Yeah.
Memorial Day.
Turns out, our idea already existed.
Yeah. Well, just like us, to come up with a new idea that already existed. Excuse us. But here's the thing. Nobody had been doing a Survivor podcast before us, and now everybody's doing a Survivor podcast. We were the first, okay? You can look at the records. Nobody else was doing one until we started doing one. We are the only one. So it's actually, we are trailblazers, I believe. We're the Portland Trailblazers.
Yeah, we're innovators. We're disruptors. You know, we're entrepreneurs, self-starters, creators.
We have created at least two jobs, and that is recording this podcast for the two of us.
Which really is like a full-time job. It's not something that we just half-ass and, you know, do for one, you know, maybe hour-long max record, and then, you know, however long it takes to edit.
Well, I think, I don't know how you do it, but after I get done watching the episode, if it's only been like 42 minutes, I then watch it again until I get to 40 hours of watching the episode. So I can come in to the recording session like fully certain of what happened in the episode.
Well, also, you know, we gotta get enough hours in so that, you know, we get benefits.
Obviously. So. Yeah.
Because, like, look, if I'm going to be watching, you know, season 4 of Survivor, I better be getting health insurance.
Speaking of season 4 of Survivor, Thomas, did you watch Survivor Marquesas last night? Some folks are born made to
wave the flag. Ooh, they're red, white, and blue. I did. I watched it for 38 hours.
Oh, wow. Congrats. So you are an expert on what happened, I'm sure. No point will I ask you, hey, do you remember when this happened? And you'll say, I was playing
I watched it so many times, it would be impossible.
Yeah. Impossible to miss it. So you know for a fact that this week's episode was called, in fact, The Wind's Twist. What do you think of that episode title?
Not bad.
Not bad. I would agree. First aired on March 20th, 2002.
Wow.
Thomas, how old
would
you have been?
You would have been 11 years old.
I'm not asking how old I would have been. How old would you have been, Thomas?
I would have been 10 years old.
Oh, I would have been exactly 11 years old. No more, no less.
What a birthday present for you.
It truly was. Last week's episode received 20.46 million viewers and saw Hunter get voted out. Do you think Hunter's ousting increased or decreased the viewership?
I'm going to say this got 20.4 million. I'm going to say it lost 0.06 million.
Mm. Well, actually, Thomas, I was having a birthday party that day. And 2.5 million of my favorite friends came over to watch with me. So this week, actually, it received 22.81 million viewers.
Wow.
Yeah.
Apparently people were just really fed up with Hunter.
Yeah, well, they were like, we can't have any fighter pilots on this season. What is this, Memorial Day? And it is, because we're remembering Hunter now.
Yeah, R.I.P. We're remembering Harry Connick Jr. from Independence Day, when he got blown up, and Will Smith was very sad about it.
Yeah, I mean, it was a sad moment, and we will remember that forever. We start off on the Meramu tribe. Meramu? How do you say it?
Meramau? I don't know.
That's not it. That's definitely not it. Rob is proud of himself for taking out Hunter. Gina was convinced it was going to be her. Over on the Rotu tribe, it's all calm and peaceful. And Kathy makes toasted coconut for everyone. Do you love Kathy yet? She's making toasted coconut.
No, but I don't. I think she's calmed down a little bit, which is good.
Yeah, certainly. Well, you know, when you got toasted coconut every day, how can you not be in a good
mood?
I mean,
look, if Kathy's going to make me toasted coconut, my opinion is going to change very quickly.
Absolutely.
Jake, do you like coconut?
No, it's one of my least favorite flavors.
Damn, all right. It really is. It is a classic love it or hate it food. It's one of my favorites. I love coconut.
It's one of the reasons I haven't been trying out for a Survivor Harder, because like, I really don't want to eat that many coconuts.
Is it no a offense. Texture thing?
It's a texture thing, but also a taste thing. I just don't care for it. Interesting.
I like both. I feel like most of the time people say they just don't like the texture, which I love. So,
they're also ugly. They're ugly fruits. I don't want
to
eat a fruit
that's ugly. What
does
that have to do with anything?
I want a good-looking fruit like an apple or a cherry, not these weird coconuts. Get out of here with this shit. Give me a rutabaga, a potato, something from the ground. Coconuts.
Yeah, from the
get
earth.
Out of here. That's how you know you can trust it. Okay, then we get into this tribe swap. Everybody stands on a disc and then uncovers it. How do you feel about doing the tribe swap this way?
I prefer to have buffs thrown.
Just at random.
Yeah.
Okay, sure. That's fun. I like this. I like that everybody just had to stand there and then figure it out. And also I liked that Jeff didn't tell them what was happening until it was happening, and they had to figure it out on their own. That was fun.
Yeah, it was cool.
Nalia swaps to Marimu. Well, how did you pronounce it? Marimu?
Marimau.
Marimau.
Sure. Marshmallow.
Viseppi and Rob join Rotu. Kathy joins Marimu. Marimau. I don't know why I'm having such trouble.
Every time that you say Viseppi, I think you're saying Giuseppe. I'm like, there's someone named Giuseppe on this season?
Mm-mm. Viseppi. Sean and Robert also going to Rotu. Ronu, you might call it. Pascal goes to Marimu. Marimu. Marinu. Eh? Tammy Jones Rotu.
Yeah, we'll work on it.
On the Marinu tribe, huh? You just have to say it enough and it'll catch on.
I feel like you're the crow in that comic where you're looking at your cards and it's just that.
Yeah.
Get better material.
Marinu, Ronu. It's good. It's good. We do it every time we can. Remember when there was a tribe called Nuku and we just called them New Nuku or something like that? Good
yes,
times.
I do remember tough. That.
Okay, so on the Marinu tribe, Kathy is pleased with her new camp, as is Nalia, because they have all this new fruit. Gina and Kathy both are leaving their careers to go into environmentalism, so they bond over that. Wasn't that a nice moment? Do you love Kathy?
It was a nice moment. It was like when I was in Las Vegas for Summer League, and I found out somebody had the same birthday as me that I had just met.
Mm, that's cool. That's fun. I once dated somebody very briefly and found out that I had the same birthday as one of her roommates, but then I never met that roommate before breaking up with her.
They could have been lying to you. You don't know. That person
they
might not exist.
They could have been. They could have been. I also apparently matched with that roommate on some dating app at one point, and then we
never
talked.
Oh, man. How much would it have ruled if you were dating somebody with the same birthday as you?
It would have been great. Very happy to be out of the dating scene. It sucks, man.
No, we're not talking about this on our Survivor podcast.
No, let's do like 20 minutes on dating in the modern world.
Women, am I right?
Women date like this.
It's all about you guys heard about this ghosting stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Crazy.
Ghost Island, more like it. So on the Ronu tribe, Viseppia is shocked by how much everybody is working. How did you feel about that perfect segue back into Survivor, Thomas?
I'm glad. I'm glad it happened.
Thank you. Rob is worried that about how he'll work with the new tribe members because Rob hates working. Rob and Sean really hate how much chores they have to do.
They don't do anything. Like,
all they do is pretend to interview each other for their radio show. And then they also say that the only girl on their new tribe is John. Cool joke, guys. Very
yeah,
funny.
Well, they were, because Rob was like, one of them is married. And I don't remember what his problem was with somebody else. And then he's like, John probably, he tries to like assert that he's in charge. So he probably has, does he say he has like a little sausage or something like that?
Oh, is that what he was saying? I was assuming it was.
He also says the thing about John being the only girl on the tribe later, but
yeah, I thought he was saying that because
did people
he's
like
gay.
Rob after this season?
No.
He's a villain, right?
Yeah. He was on the villains tribe on Heroes
yeah,
vs. Villains.
Yeah, because he fucking sucks.
Yeah. Yeah, he's bad. He's such a charming fellow, though. And that smile, how can you not love Boston Rob?
As they don't do any work. But also, aren't they like, we're gonna narrow it down and vote somebody off, and then I think they very quickly realize that, like, they're gonna get voted off. And mm-hmm. then they don't even try to do anything about it.
Yeah, I don't get it. Yeah, Tammy is also displeased with their lack of working. Tammy is your favorite person on this season, right? The crime reporter?
Oh, yeah. I don't know. I like Tammy okay. I think she was the one... she did a good job reporting on that one guy in the jail cell. I don't they say, like, when she's bringing stuff, it's like, if she keeps bringing stuff, then, like, we won't vote her off. But we're not going to do any work.
Yeah. I love Rob and Sean's newfound power. On the Mara New tribe, they get lost on the hike, and they... eventually find water and catch some shrimp. This was a fun little scene. Sarah tries to head back to camp because she's getting really bit bad by the no-nos, but can't find the trail on her own, so she has to come back to these people who are complaining about her. Great scene. I love shit like this. I want more of it. Jeff, I know you love Fiji, but you gotta go other places. You gotta stick people in these new locations. It's so fun to watch.
I know that it's Jeff's only way to fulfill his dream of going to Fiji like Truman from the mm-hmm. Truman Show, but we got to go some other places too.
And you may recall we have never watched the Truman Show for this podcast, even though it would make a lot of sense if we did that, but we never have. So maybe in the future we will. That's all I'm saying.
Something to think about.
Something to think about. Like that song, this is the Music Minute. Remember that song? On the Road to Tribe, Sean tells off Gabriel because he's working too much. Well, I didn't follow this scene. It seems like every once in a while there's just a scene of people shouting at each other.
You know who else didn't follow that scene? Gabe. He was just like, all right, well, he's going to yell at me. I'm just going to sit here.
But not you, because you watched this 38 times.
Yeah. Well, I did. Look, he didn't have the... You don't have the luxury of getting to replay the conversation you just had 38 times, but...
Mm-hmm.
It really was just Sean being like, nobody said anything to them about them not working, and then him coming up and being like, yeah, I'm going to be real about not working, because, like, we know that we're already going to get voted off, so we're not going to try, and Gabe was just like, okay.
Yeah, okay. Vesepia assures Rob and Sean that she is still with them. She doesn't care for any of this drama, though, and says, if my name's not in it, then I'm not in it.
Vesepia got the right attitude about this. Yeah. Just lay low.
It's like, I'm not going to worry about it. I'm not involved. On the Marimu tribe, Sarah sleeps wrapped in an American flag. How did you feel about that?
My first thought was, is that Pascal's American flag?
I believe it is, yes. I wonder how...
I mean, he must have let her do it, but I was like, man, I thought he really cared about that flag.
Mm.
Is sleeping with a flag desecrating it? That's what I want to know.
I did have that thought a lot of times. And, you know, it was front of mind because it is Memorial Day, the day in which we remember the flag. So
we remember the fallen survivor players like Sarah.
Yeah. Kathy expects Rotu to throw the next challenge to get rid of their new people. Were you expecting that at all?
I thought about it, but the minute that they showed an interview with her saying that, I was like, oh, they're going to win.
At the immunity challenge, they have to unscramble a woven tapestry. I thought this was a cool challenge.
I liked it a lot. Again, it's just very different from what I'm used to.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little more creative, not as elaborate.
Yeah, I would like to see it come back in some way. Row 2 wins. Once again, no surprise there. Mara Amu, is that right? Gina is targeting...
Why not? I think any answer you come up with will be correct. There are no wrong answers.
That's correct on Survivor. Gina is targeting Sarah because she seems to have given up, I guess. But Sarah wants to take out Kathy. Cool. All right. So that's where we stand, but heading into tribal council. There's no wildlife shots this week, so we're going to skip that segment. At tribal council, Pascal says he's happy with the change. Gina is happy with the change. Kathy tries to remain positive. Malia is disappointed by the swap, but is happy now that they've been together for a little longer. And the final vote is Sarah gets 3, Kathy gets only 1. What were you sad to see Sarah go?
Not especially. I don't think she really added that much to this season.
Yeah. After she and Rob got separated, she didn't really have much more of a plot line or a character at all. I kind of forgot who she was until right now.
Yeah, just wasn't really contributing in any way.
Yeah.
In terms of to the tribe or storylines, so.
Who do you think wins? Have you figured out yet?
Been reading the fact that you keep asking me how I feel about Kathy makes me think maybe Kathy won.
Interesting. But who do you think? If it weren't for me asking about Kathy, who do you think it was?
I don't know. I don't think that I have a firm handle on it yet.
Wow. 4 episodes in. I know who won because, as I already mentioned, I watched this on my 11th birthday. So, pretty exciting stuff.
Yeah, definitely.
Thomas, did you watch the Challenge All-Stars last night? Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to
the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Jake, I didn't. When is this going to be over? Like, is this a finale?
Yeah, this is it. This
Part 2
is the
of the final, right?
Yeah. Who do you know who won?
The viewers. We all won.
It was
Did
yes.
Did TJ thank the viewers?
No, he didn't, but we can. Thomas, can you thank the viewers, listeners? We have listeners. We're not a YouTube show. Come on. What is this, 2002?
Yeah. I want to thank the viewers. You know, couldn't do it without you.
Yeah, great job, guys. Yes won the thing. He won Challenge All-Stars, so... I didn't even know Yes existed before watching this season, and then he won the whole thing. So good for him. Thomas, what's your Twitter?
You can follow me at TomNotTom. If you guys were to give us the Patreon money so that we could do Just Joey, we would probably do a special episode talking about how... there's a picture from the Friends reunion of Matt LeBlanc that is apparently looks Irish people think it looks like an Irish uncle, so they've just been doing a bunch of memes of like that picture, but with him saying things that like your Irish uncle would say. It's just some Joey related news.
And you love that because you, as we have discussed previously, are Irish and have a strong Irish temper.
You've got
Joey.
That Irish temper. So I thought people were making fun of the Irish for a second, so I got a little mad. But then when I calmed down, I realized that it was Irish people that were making the joke. So it's okay.
Yeah. Irish people can make fun of Irish people.
Yeah.
That's fine. I'm not
fine
Irish, so I would never.
I'm just like the people that live in Ireland. So it's fine if we do it.
Mm-hmm. I will get blackout drunk on St. Patrick's Day, though. That's fine, right?
But if you're not Irish, oof, Malone. That's not okay.
No. You can follow the show on Twitter at DYWSLN if you want to do that, or on Instagram at The Only Survivor Podcast. We already thank the fans. Well, we thank the viewers, but basically the same thing. If you wanted to leave an iTunes review, Thomas, can you give them the boilerplate review? People have not been leaving reviews, and I can't understand why.
Yeah, well, I mean, we keep telling them, but I'll keep telling them. Okay. 5 stars, please. Do we still have our special rate going for Patreon? Is it still 20% off?
Unfortunately, the Just Joey Patreon 20% off discount has expired, so... Honestly, it's still economical. It's only $10,000.
It's still a great deal.
A month to get access to Just Joey. And for some reason, nobody has taken us up on it yet. But if you do, we'll start producing the episodes. So just head on over to patreon.com/ I don't know, whatever. You'll be able to find it.
You figure it out. It's not our job. Google's free. It's not our job to explain this to you.
Just Google Patreon Just Joey. You'll find it.
I'm not going to do emotional labor by explaining to you where to go.
Look, URLs are hard to read sometimes.
I'm already doing so much emotional labor telling you how to leave a good review for this show.
Yeah, how is that again?
Okay, 5 stars. This is my favorite podcast. I like it better than all of the other podcasts. I give it a big thumbs up.
I love to hear that. This is a short episode this week.
I can't believe our viewers are so... our viewers...
They're fucking entitled. They're like, we're viewers. Give us some video.
Oh, yeah, they're so manipulative. They make me tell them how to do everything when Google is free.
Google's free. Google's free. Just Google what a good boilerplate review would be. You'll be able to find it. Or listen to any episode Thomas does the boilerplate review.
It's not my job to educate the viewers.
And people keep, they keep calling themselves viewers. Like they're viewing us, but they're not. They're, if anything, they're reviewers, but they're not because they're not reviewing us on iTunes.
Yeah. You know what? I take it back. I don't thank the fans.
No thanks.
You're
to
all
fans.
Parasites.
No thanks,
they're
to
leeches.
Viewers.
They're just they're cloud sharks, man. They're just trying to leech off all my energy.
Man, if these fans aren't careful, they're gonna get on the bleep list themselves.
Yeah, that's right.
If you don't want to be on the bleep list,
we're gonna ban the fans from the show. That'll teach them.
How about this? How about this? If you don't leave us a review, you're going on the bleep list. We know everybody
is that
listens
what you
to
want?
This podcast.
Do you want
to
be like?
No, oh, god damn it!
It sure sounds like it.
I shouldn't have even tempted you. I have to go find that clip in the audio and find. You know what? No thanks to you either.
Oh, what
Thomas.
Are you gonna put me on the bleep list now, Jake? Because that'll
no,
just make
I
more
can't.
Work for you. Is that what you want?
I can't. No, you found a loophole. Have a great summer.
What if our podcast was just you bleeping out everything that I said?
Yeah, sometimes I feel like I should. It's just me going on long rants about some show I watch, and then you just being bleeped for a few seconds, and then going into another 5-minute rant about something.
I wonder
something.
What Tom said.
Unimportant. It's only me. Have a great summer, I said.
Deuces. Got out of town. Was making for the trades on the outside and the downhill run to Papeete off the wind on this heading like the Marquesas. You got 80 feet of a waterline nicely making way in a noisy bar in Avalon. On a midnight watch, I realized why twice you ran away. Think about how many times I had fallen. Spirits are using me, larger voices call. Yeah, often miss.
Often miss. Give me a green tooth, AOC, right?
Oh!
Not in my country.
Yeah, that's
blue's
right.
The only tooth I want. Blue tooth, no matter who tooth,
green
am I right?
New tooth.
Yeah. I don't...
I'm actually the head writer for Gutfeld now.
It's a good joke.
I'm sailing for tomorrow, my dreams are dying, and my love is an anchor tied to you,
tied with a silver chain.
I have my ship, and all her flags are a
smarten up, Probst.